Hello everyone, I am Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and you are watching my YouTube channel, Double Electrics. The topic of this short lecture is direct current machines, torque equation. It is well known to us, when the current carrying armature conductors are placed in the magnetic field, a torque is produced which causes the armature conductors to rotate in the magnetic field. So in this short lecture, we will deduce the expression for the torque produced. However, before deducing the expression for torque, let us first consider the cases of separately excited and shunt excited DC motors. You must note that for both separately excited and shunt excited DC motors, the voltage across the armature ends, which is represented as VA, would be the same as the terminal voltage VT. Hence, we may represent the current voltage relationship for these two sorts of DC motors as VA is equal to EB plus IARA. This is to remind you that the current and voltage relationships in DC machine have already been discussed by me in one of my short lecture in this series. Now, consider the cases of series excited as well as short shunt and long shunt compound DC motors. For these three sorts of DC motors, the current and voltage relationships can be expressed as VT is equal to EB plus IARA plus ISERAC. Rearranging this equation, we have VT minus ISERSE is equal to EB plus IARA. However, this is worth mentioning here that VT minus ISERSE is nothing but the voltage across the armature ends, that is VA. Hence, we may also represent the current voltage relationship for these three sorts of DC motors as VA is equal to EB plus IARA. This way, based on the previous discussions, we may now formally write the current voltage relationship for any DC motor as VA is equal to EB plus IARA. Now, multiply both the sides by IA. We have VA IA is equal to EB IA plus IA square RA. Now, it is interesting to see that the first term in this equation is nothing but the power input to the armature of the DC motor, while the third term represents the power loss in the armature. Therefore, in view of this fact, the second term must be the mechanical power developed by the armature. So we may now express the mechanical power developed by the armature, that is PM, is equal to EB into IA. Now, PM may further be expressed as the product of mechanical torque produced, that is TM, and the angular speed of armature in mechanical radian per second. Therefore, the product of PM and omega M is equal to EB IA. This way, the expression for torque is given by EB IA over omega M. Further, when rotational speed of armature is given in RPM, we may represent omega M as 2 pi N over 60. So the torque equation is finally represented by this equation. Once again, this is to remind you that the motor action and generator action occur simultaneously in DC machines. In view of this fact, whenever a DC machine is operated as a generator, motor action also occurs simultaneously, which in turn results into the production of a counter torque. This concept has already been discussed by me in one of my short lectures in this series. Now, it is worth mentioning here that the expression of torque remains the same no matter whether the DC machine is operating as a motor or as a generator. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.